Salton Sea, Southern California, March 2013. Thousands of rotting fish wash up on the shoreline of this giant lake. Ed Simpson at Kutztown University in Pennsylvania thinks prevailing winds only make matters worse.
The invitation came as a result of a presentation we gave at the National Geologic Society of America meeting in 2013 in Denver, Colorado. Live Science, who's an online science magazine, sent a reporter to our poster session. She liked the poster. She wrote it up, and it became a featured article on livescience.com. The Pioneer Communications, who has produced the segment, The Strangest Weather on Earth, picked up, noticed that article, contacted me, and I sent them a whole series of information. They pitched it to the producer, and they picked it up as part of the new series on the Weather Channel. What the Weather Channel is going to focus on is an occurrence of spheres of what is called Adipocere, which is basically parts of dead fish. And this is an unusual occurrence that has never been described anywhere else in the world. And what happens is it is related to high wind events that take place on the Salton Sea. So what we did was we collected these spheres and brought them back to the laboratory where our analytical chemist Tom Betts did the chemistry on them. Kurt Freehoff and a student did the scanning electron microscope work, and another student did some more chemistry on it. So it's a multi-pronged project, and the Weather Channel was interested in this weather, wind, and unusual occurrence of these spheres at the Salton Sea. What we typically do here at Kutztown is we will find a scientific problem and we'll set undergraduates on it. And the fact that this work has been recognized internationally is an affirmation and tells us we're doing, at Kutztown, we're doing significant scientific research that can be brought out to scientists across the world. And that opportunity opens, that recognition opens up lots of opportunities for students to go to graduate school, to do a variety of things, because they get the publications on their vitas, and it just recognition of what kind of work they did as an undergraduate. The feature will be aired November 9th at 9 p.m. on the Weather Channel. We look forward to seeing KU research featured in a national outlet.